And now Storm Tracker weather with meteorologist Michael Ottavino.
Temperatures out there this morning, certainly not as cool as they could be for this time of year. In Pocatello, a little bit warmer compared to yesterday at 30 degrees. We're at 16 in Idaho Falls, 14 across the Jackson area. Yesterday, you were below zero. Sam, it is a bit cooler, coming in at 10 degrees. And to give you an idea of how much warmer it is across the Snake River Plain compared to yesterday, 8 degrees warmer in Pocatello, just a few degrees warmer in Idaho Falls. Other areas are a bit cooler. We did have a cold front pass through, and you may be saying, why is it warmer for this morning? Well, we have plenty of clouds that are making their way into our area, part of another disturbance that did push just south of us, so that's keeping temperatures a bit warmer for this morning. You will notice throughout the day it will certainly be much cooler. Highs today only into the 30s. We were in the upper 40s yesterday across Pocatello, so again, it will be cooler for today. Notice no snow across the Gem State just yet. Look out to the northwest and also into the Pacific. Lots of moisture. These are a series of our next systems that will begin to make their way into our area starting as soon as tomorrow night into the Saturday time frame, which is when we'll get our first band of potential accumulating snow making its way into our area. Let's take a look at the future tracker for today. Lots of clouds out there. Notice when I put it in motion, the model really clears those clouds out throughout the day. I think the clouds will stick around. We'll call it mostly cloudy throughout the morning, and then we'll see periods of clouds and sunshine throughout the afternoon. Not much in terms of snow for today. We may see a few flurries into the overnight, but we'll see some scattered snow showers out there for tomorrow throughout the day, 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. Highlands, western Wyoming, not really much expected in terms of accumulation during the day for tomorrow, but we will get a band of snow that will build in Friday night into Saturday morning. So when you wake up on Saturday, we could see up to about 2 inches for the highest of terrain, and then even locally across the Snake River Plain, parts of us may see that as well. This band of snow may actually be further south, which could limit accumulations for areas further north. But regardless, I know skiers are definitely excited for the snow on the way. For today, across the Snake River Plain, mixture of clouds and sun by this afternoon. High temperatures up to about 10 degrees cooler compared to yesterday. We'll be at 37 in Pocatello, 35 in Idaho Falls, 34 in Rexburg. Central Mountains also expect to see a mixture of clouds and sun. I think that the clouds will dissipate from your area first compared to what we'll see across the Snake River Plain. High temperatures going to be mostly into the 30s. And for the highlands in the western half of Wyoming, clouds and sun as well. High temperatures into the 20s and the 30s. And then for tonight, much cooler out there. Temperatures into the teens for the valleys. Single digits for some of the higher terrain. Will be partly cloudy for tonight. And then a few snow showers expected for tomorrow morning. For your Southeast Idaho Chevy dealer 7-day forecast, high temperature of 33 tomorrow in Pocatello, 32 on Saturday. Again, snow making its way into our area Friday night into the first half of Saturday, and then more will be on the way for Sunday into Monday as well. And we pretty much have chances of snow in our forecast after today for the next 6 days. Idaho Falls, snow showers possible tomorrow. Better chance of snow Friday night into Saturday. And for the Teton area, lots of snow in the 7-day forecast after today.